Bonjour à tous. Alors, on a pas mal de démos qui se passent sur le web et on a les IP qui sautent, donc il y aura certainement des démos effects. Si vous voulez contribuer à ce que la démo se passe bien, merci de tous éteindre vos ordinateurs pour être sûr qu'on garde l'IP. Bon, c'est vraiment si vous avez envie, hein, sinon ça arrangera. Donc, merci d'être ici. Je vous présente Xavier, moi c'est Mickaël et nous allons vous présenter une... Nous allons vous faire une présentation. Sorry, ah yes, it meant to me in English. Yeah, sorry. So we are here to present you how we leverage different build and quality technologies in order to set up a first-class environment dedicated to Eclipse plugin and OSGI bundle development. So the goal of this presentation is starting from what everybody know here, which is build automation and continuous integration, to go one step further in order to start taking into account the code quality when developing. What do we mean by code quality? Code quality is a set of different metrics, which can be duplication, code command, code coverage, complexity of code, and this quality describe what how your code does the thing. It does not describe the quality of the feature, but it describes the quality of the code by itself. And why is it important? It is because if you have bad quality, you won't be able to maintain your code easily. So good code quality is necessary if you want sustainable software, easy to maintain, easy for new developer to use, and easy to rely on for decades if you are in long-term production. So that's all for code quality. We will start to explain you Tyco.
So we will explain you the tool we rely on to build and to have continuous improvement in the context of Eclipse plugin and OSGI bundles. So the first tool we use is Tyco. So Tyco is some Maven extensions for Eclipse and OSGI. And it allows you to build some Eclipse-specific projects such as plugin, features, update site. We will see that later during the demo. And Tyco is non-intrusive. It means that you only need to add some configuration on your project and almost you don't need to remove or change existing stuff on your plugins and so on. And it brings you all the power of Maven. So how does it work? So Tyco delegates the handling of the dependencies to the manifest.mf. So it's the classical way to handle dependencies in Eclipse plugins. But in Maven, you usually define your dependencies on the dependencies tag. And Tyco will delegate that part to the manifest. And it will also delegate the project structure to the build properties of your plugin project. So it will rely on the existing build structure and dependencies. Tyco also adds some specific packaging to indicate Maven that it should handle the dependency resolution and the project structure through the manifest and the build properties. So you see there are some packaging types. And you also need to define some target platform. So the target platform is the set of features and plugin your application will run. So there is three ways to define that. The first way, it's by specifying the location of an Eclipse installation. So it's hard to maintain because it means you need to have that Eclipse installation on each developing computer for each team member. Second way to do that is to use target platform. So it's the classical way to handle the target platform for Eclipse. It's okay for developing, but because Eclipse can automatically configure your target platform, but for the build it won't work because you can't rely to Eclipse plugin and stuff like this from your IDE. And so the way we should we recommend to do that is to use the target platform in your pom.xml. So if you are used to Maven, you will recognize that kind of tags. The only tags we add is the layout one to indicate it's a P2 repository. So a P2 repository is a kind of repository as we have in the Maven world, but for Eclipse. And finally, you can add a parent pom to aggregate some common build settings and so on. So we will do a quick demo. So here we are in the manifest.mf, and for Eclipse development, you see the require bundle tag, where you can indicate the dependencies of your plugin there. And if you go to the pom.xml of that plugin project, you'll see it's only 10 lines of code where you define the parent and the packaging, the main thing you should define. And by indicating that this project is an Eclipse plugin, it means Tycho will resolve by itself the dependencies in the manifest.mf and the project structure in the build properties too. So here we are presenting where the dependency will be resolved. So we saw the plugin is depending from some dependencies from eclipse.core and so on, and you will find them on this repository. So it's defined on the parent. You define all the repository you rely on in the parent pom, and then you can define the use of Tycho just there in the build section. Just by doing that, you enable the use of Tycho and the use of the packaging types and so on. Okay then. After that, we can maybe show some test pom. Some. And then you can define, as you do it in a classical Java project, you can still define the plugins you need during your build. There is some specific plugins, but you will recognize Surefire, which will orchestrate your tests. And that's all. You just need to know Maven, and you will be able to use Tycho in that context. So if we launch a build, you'll see we launch classical command lines. Okay. So this one will be a bit. Yes. Wait, to go faster, we won't run an integration test because it will spend some time. So as you can see, we just run a clean install, a classic one. So there is nothing fancy, nothing magic. It's just common sense, and it will be okay. So everybody is understanding so far? Okay. And here the build success. Okay, so just to show you that with 10 lines of XML you can run a build with Tycho. So the next step obviously is to put that build on continuous integration. On that one. So again, because you rely on Maven, it's quite easy to integrate it with Jenkins. So it's a classical Maven project, and where you define just the goal and some profiles and even options. Here the nothing fancy again. And that's it.
So the first achievement is unlocks. Without a lot of pain, you succeeded to set up automation for an Eclipse build. For people who already did Eclipse development in the last 4 years, let's say, I sure you understand that it was painful before Tycho to build Eclipse plugins or Eclipse application. Now Tyco makes it very easy just by adding some POM, not intrusive, and you can easily get it into Jenkins, which is a very big added value. So now we have a build that we can repeat, we can run tests, we can see test results, but how to analyze quality? That's the topic of the presentation. Especially, we have a lot of bundles, and it is Eclipse applications are very modular, and what we want is a dashboard for the whole project. That can be an issue sometime, to have a report for a set of modules instead of having report for each module. And also, as I said, code quality implies a lot of other tools such as coverage, rules relation, duplication, and so on. And this is generally provided one tool gives you one report or a few reports. If you want to have reports about everything, it is difficult to have a global view of your quality. So you can easily have a look at how much you duplicate code, but it is not easy to see if you should more focus on duplicated code or more on rule violation because you don't have a global dashboard. And that's why we interested in Sonar. Sonar, for those who don't know it, is a code quality platform which will push you when your project is under Sonar, you get a lot of reports about most quality metrics. Some of them are the one provided by classical tools such as Findbugs, PMD, Checkstyle, and some other metrics are internal to Sonar, but you can consume them. For your information, Sonar is an open source product. So let's just show you how we can easily set up Sonar.
So in Jenkins, you have a lot of plugins, so you obviously have a plugin to enable Sonar analysis. So if we go down in that configuration, you'll see that, yes, but we have but you can do it on that one, it's a local one too, but it won't be the same. So okay, just if you can check a checkbox, you are able to launch Sonar analysis during your build, and that's it. So previously to that, you need obviously to configure your Sonar instance, but you can do that by yourself or rely on stuff like CloudBees and so on. And when you run your build, you can see the results of Sonar. If you go to Sonar. So because of the network issues, it's not a real project. We did the presentation on a real Eclipse plugin, and we can't show you that, but we can show you on the small project I presented you. Here is Sonar, and you can have a closer look at Sonar and see how you can use it for your own process. So here you have your second achievement. So you are starting to put your technical debt under control. It means that you have a clear view of what's going on your code, and you can act accordingly to that. But there is a missing piece. For now, we presented you just some metrics such as code violations and complexity, the percentage of comments, and so on. But we haven't presented you the code coverage part. So how to do that in a context of an Eclipse development? For Java developers, it seems a bit silly, but actually it's a nightmare to analyze the code coverage of your code in an Eclipse context. So we will rely on Jack Oko, and Mikael will present it. Will present that for you.
Sorry for the troubles with this pop-up. Jacoco is a very, 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 very powerful code coverage tool. So if you use anything else than Jacoco for code coverage, you should stop immediately. On this slide, you learn all you need to know to set up Jacoco on any JVM application. Setting up Jacoco is just about setting a Java agent property to your JVM. There is no need for instrumentation at build time. There is no need for instrumented jar. You just set this Java agent on your JVM and you will get code coverage reports for your tests or even for the smarter use case for usage report. It is also available in an even more convenient way for the Maven world, since Jacoco provides a Maven plugin. And this Maven plugin is just a few lines to put in your parent pom.xml, and it will set for you the argline for your test. So your argline will contain the dash Java agent equal jacoco.jar. So you don't have to play a lot with getting the jar and giving the nice path and file system. A small tip, if you want to try it immediately, because I think if you want to start using Jacoco now, you will end by result within the end of the talk. So there is no difficulty really in setting up Jacoco. A tip is that when you use the Jacoco plugin, it sets the Tyco.test argline if you use Tyco ShowFire plugin, or the argline if you use a normal ShowFire plugin. So what you sometimes have to do is repeating the arguments in your ShowFire configuration in order to not override it by some configuration of yours. This is the only pitfall currently to this bundle, to this Maven ShowFire plugin. And actually, it is not really a pitfall of the Maven ShowFire plugin. It is more of the Maven Jacoco plugin. It is more a pitfall in the ShowFire plugin, which does not accept extensible argline or pluggable argline. So very concretely about this, very concretely about this Jacoco Maven plugin, here is a profile you can almost copy paste directly in your POM, and this profile, I hate Mac. Really. And in this profile, you can see that it is just a matter of setting the Jacoco Maven plugin. As you can see, the Jacoco Maven plugin. And you have a very, I switched it off, but the end of the presentation, we should show something online, so it's a bit frustrating. No matter. So yeah, the Jacoco Maven plugin, let's go back to the presentation. It's just a matter of invoking the plugin with the right goal. I think there is only one goal, so you cannot get confused. And you have a few things to configure. Probably the most important one is the append flag that you should set to true in order to get a single coverage report for all your tests, which is much more useful to have than having a dozen of test reports that you have to read one by one, and which is much more comfortable for Sonar, which who really prefer having only one report file. And you have also to set up the death file, which is the file where report will be. I don't think it's difficult. Some additions you can see directly in this profile are the Sonar configuration properties, which tells Sonar when you use the Sonar plugin that we showed in the previous demonstration, which tells Sonar that it will have to, that it has some Jacoco reports available and in which directory it can find them. So with that, you immediately get Jacoco to work. Time for a demo, which is an offline demo, so there won't be any pop-up anymore, I hope. So here, I put this Jacoco plugin in my code recommenders Code Recommenders project, which is a very nice Eclipse project that you should really try. It helps you to be very more productive by guessing what you should write and not what you will write. You don't have to look on the web anymore. It has the web in it and it tells you after this you should write that, and then you have even less things to do to develop in Eclipse with it. So I have this recommender project and I will import a coverage report that was generated during my build. The plugin which does that is Eclema, E-C-L-E-2-M-A. It is called after EMA, the code coverage, but it now supports Jacoco as well. It supports even Jacoco better than EMA, I guess. And here we say, we give it the path to the jacoco.exe file, and we say this jacoco.exe file relates to the following project. And let's finish. It's working. Okay. And so we can... okay. And here you can see reports about code coverage for all these bundles. As you can see, the code coverage on this particular build is not that good, but no matter for the demonstration, because we did the necessary to keep a good code coverage in one class. And you know for each class of all your projects how much your tests cover it. And for developers, it is pretty useful because I see, for example, I want checks to be covered at 100% because it's a masterclass or something like that. I open this class. And this one. Okay. Checks. Where is it? And then you see directly on the class the result of coverage. You see in red the lines that are not covered, in yellow the ones that are not covered in branches, in all branches, and in green lines that are covered. So this tool is pretty easy to set up in your build and is pretty easy to consume in your developer IDE. So you should really try it. It's configuring is just a matter of changing a POM. Using it is just a matter of installing Eclema on Eclipse. And something more is that you don't only care about your developer having this code coverage report, you also care about having this code coverage part of your dashboard. Because it can happen that someone just wants to have an overview of the quality. For example, in QE teams, that's what they do. Maybe they don't have the code, they don't have the projects in their IDE or something like that. And putting it into Sonar with the few properties you saw in the pom.xml earlier will just display reports on this page, so you can know from Sonar, started from a build integrated. Which one do you want to open?
It's an unbug that when a class reach 100% of code coverage in Sonar, it's not displayed, so you won't see that class by that way. But if you go.
We will try to reactivate airport to show you a more concrete use case, yeah. Which is the one of Code Recommenders, which is a project we just show you. And then if we go, let's say there, and then where is it? Here, click archive. On okay. Okay, so you can see in Sonar the same thing as you can see in in Eclema. So just to sum it up, here we started from Maven project, an Eclipse project. We added a few POM, which are the most magic part of the demonstration. We then set it up into Jenkins, which was the second most easy part of the demonstration. We run it, we got test report, we just installed the Sonar plugin and checked the Sonar checkbox on the job. Then we add a quality report in Sonar. And then we set up Jacoco with a simple Maven plugin, and we now have feedback of code coverage in both the IDE and Sonar. So since all these steps are easy one by one, it may be difficult to understand that this is the very first steps toward continuous improvement. Indeed, before that, what did you have? You had a build running somewhere with some test report, and you knew your code was bad for something or some other, and you didn't spend money on improving the code just because you didn't know it was crap. And now you know, and knowing you have things to improve is the first step necessary to improve those things. And here, with a very few steps, we could do that for our Eclipse use case, but you could easily do that for any Java use case, since Sonar works for Java. It also works for .NET and so on. Jenkins works for any project. And the Maven Sonar plugin works for any Java project. So now you are really heading towards continuous improvement.
We will thank Nicolas Deloff for providing us a good support for our Cloud Biz instance,
which does not work offline, sadly, so you could not really see it.
Sorry. And you can find some resources. The most important one is the Maven profile, and it's a gist on GitHub. And if you have Eclipse project, just copy paste it. If you have a Tycho project, actually, just copy paste it on your parent POM, and it should work almost out of the box. So there is also two bugs you should follow if you're interested on that topic. The first one is having a Sonar instance for Eclipse, so you'll find the bug to follow that topic. And the second one is having a Jacoco plugin for Jenkins to consume Jacoco execution reports on your code, and having code coverage directly from Jenkins. So if you can't have a Sonar, you can have that at least Jacoco and code coverage reports in Jenkins. And that's all. If you have any question.
Yes. Can we imagine we have several jobs in Jenkins, and is it possible to merge the results of the code coverage?
Yes, since that's the purpose of the append flag on the Maven job, which is also a property when you set dash java agent jacoco.jar append equal true, which simply, if you have several run of the JVM, if all run specify append and point to the same location for the jacoco.exec, it just adds the coverage to the previous one. So it's sequential add. So you can have, that's something we are thinking about for JBoss tools, which is to use Jacoco as a usage report collector, where we could think about all execution of JBoss tools on a user machine to create Jacoco report over, let's say, 2 months of usage. And 2 months later, we try to get back this jacoco.exec, and we will actually know which piece of code are used by the user and which one are not. So we could get rid of things that is totally obsolete. And there is no limitation in getting big and big Jacoco file by itself. There is no problem.
Okay then. Thank you.
Okay.